I started doing a lot of research on sugar. Mm. A few years ago, I got sick in 1991, and I have a neurotransmitter disorder, and the doctor was like, you're never going to be able to eat sugar again. Like, wait, what? Never going to be able to eat sugar again. There is sugar in
everything.
Everything. Everything. Go read a label.
Even dried fruit has everything. Fucking sugar in it. Why would you put sugar on dried fruit?
Why would you put, yeah. Topic. I love it when people get chocolate-covered banana. Maybe make it bittersweet chocolate, yeah. And it would make it dark the right dark chocolate. So it's funny. Part of that journey of getting rid of sugar, I had to convince myself the why. We need a why to be successful as people. We also need to give people their why or purpose. Bring out the why in our coaching clients. And so I started doing a lot of research on sugar. And actually, for me, it stopped becoming about obesity. And it started becoming about heart disease, cancer, diabetes, those things, and they're the silent killers. Yeah, I can look in a mirror and see that I'm fat, but I may be a fat person that thinks I'm healthy on the inside, and then we find out later, you actually have heart disease. That's actually caused by sugar. We know it now. The research is out there. Did you know that the food industry has learned how to combine sugar, fat, and salt to make it highly addictive? As addictive as crack cocaine, and it plays with your serotonin receptors. So when people say, oh, I'm addicted to sugar, you are addicted to sugar. And,
you are.
And we don't downplay it at all. Do you know why you reach for that cookie at 4 o'clock? It actually has to do, that's when your melatonin kicks in, you start to get a low. But why do you reach for sugar and not a piece of protein? I would reach for a piece of chicken now, but most people reach for the cookie. So when I started down this journey, I started looking at something that we all know as the cheat meal or the cheat day. And I couldn't understand why my clients struggled every Monday with their meal plans. So my clients send me check-ins every night, just kind of how they feel, what they ate for the day. And they always felt crappy on Mondays. Well, they always had a cheat meal on Sunday.
Yes.
Every single Sunday. And then their serotonin receptors want all of this stuff for 3 more days and they have these food cravings. Mm-hmm. And so at some point I had to go, maybe a cheat meal is actually setting up my clients to fail.
For failure.
Yeah. But what I did is I experimented on myself first. So I eliminated all cheat meals. And what I did is I did something called special occasion meals. And we can all agree that we have a special occasion at least once or twice a month. And I don't believe in healthy Christmas, healthy Thanksgiving, because we know as coaches.
Healthy Halloween.
Although I do believe in the Switch Witch, which is where your kids get all of their candy and they pick out, if your kid is 13 years old, they get to pick out 13 pieces of candy and then they leave the rest of the candy on the doorstep. And then it's taken away and like an electronic or a toy is left in its place from the Switch Witch. And so your kids aren't consuming all that candy. I think that's actually a brilliant strategy.
Or you're not consuming all that candy.
Or the mom is not, I'm not a mom, so I'm not consuming the candy, but.
I don't.
She consumes the candy. So here's the thing for me. Special occasion meals are great, and you should fully enjoy it. One meal is never going to interfere with your progress. But for me, I've gotten rid of the cheat meals in all my clients' plans, and they do instead what's called an open Sunday. They can eat anything they want on Sundays in any quantity at any time. They want 5 sweet potatoes, I don't care, as long as it's healthy. They want 5 avocados, I don't care. So when you have more calories, it actually will stimulate your metabolism as long as they are usable calories.
The right calories. So like the biggest thing within the bodybuilding industry, and I'm not knocking the body because it takes a lot of work, but.
And by the way, you're a professional athlete
I was doing bodybuilding shows.
And I coach bodybuilding athletes still to this day.
Right. But they always have this thing where you eat clean for a week and then on Sunday for that hour, you can just stuff whatever you want, like dirty bulking.
It's called dirty bulking.
And it's a horrible way. It's going to ruin your gut. It's going to ruin everything. And
it can even cause an eating disorder.
Right.
In both
and
body
I try to make it to where, first of all, a normal person or a normal lady that mostly I deal with, you're not trying to be a bodybuilder, one. But if you've restricted your body and your diet for that week, and then you consume it in that hour, you just went backwards.
so far backwards.
You just went backwards. But yeah. If you're eating a large quantity of the healthy stuff, you're not going to worry about the extra sugar or the extra processed oils. It's your body's going to use it. And then Monday morning when I'm like, pick up that 35 because I know you stuffed your face yesterday, you're not going to feel, and you're going to have that energy to do it. So,
and I will say that when you have the pizza on Sunday, oh my gosh, Monday, you're like, it's your legs are like lead. It's like, it's such an awful, just physical, not even just your serotonin levels, but awful physical feeling.
Gut health.
Your
everything
gut health.
Is
you spend a lot of time in the bathroom. Mm-hmm. I mean, once you eat clean and then you go do it.
Yeah.
Eat clean for 3 weeks.
Nothing else will taste the same and you'll pick
by the way, healthy food tastes better after you've eaten clean. Like, people are like, oh, but broccoli's so boring. Broccoli's actually really sweet.
Yeah, well, broccoli,
sweet.
And it's not the only vegetable.
Well, yeah, that's true, too. but broccoli's actually really sweet after you've stopped eating sugar for 3 weeks.
Right, and an apple. Like,
oh, my gosh.
Have an
fruit
extra
is glorious.
An apple. Like, I don't understand. Well, I can't have apple. It's a fruit. That is not your problem.
Put the fork down.
That's not your problem if you're consistent.
Well, and apples have a lot of fiber in them, too. And, right. And Americans, we just don't have enough fiber.
That's why I
said
when
diet.
People are like, he told me not to eat fruit. That's not your problem.
No, the fruit is definitely not your problem. And you know what? I'll share one more secret weapon with you. Morgan already knows it. I gave it to her a few years ago. Mm. If you eat a cucumber every morning for breakfast, it'll give you a flat stomach. You know this because
you've done it.
But we've done this with every single one of our clients that comes to us. We give them a whole cucumber peeled without the skin, and they eat it every morning. And no joke, within 5 days, they'll say, Morgan, look how flat my tummy is. And it is literally just from the fiber in that cucumber because it's so absorbable by the body. And we don't really eat enough fiber in our diets to begin with.
People don't realize, too, like your intestines will grow. Your stomach will grow. And for moms, they're like, oh, I have this baby pooch or why am I fat? I'm like, well, if I stand you up straight and I clean you out, you're not fat, right? Because people are so used to eating that stuff that sticks in your intestines.
Yeah.
And it's really hard to get out. So when you're eating clean and you're eating the cucumber.
That cucumber is glorious. So for us, and I know we coach really similarly. Mm-hmm. That's why we are your coaches at the Coach's Corner. But we coach really similarly. And we've adopted this no cheat meals, special occasion meals, and I want you to fully enjoy. No more healthy holidays. I don't know whoever created that clean cheat healthy holiday crap. Eat clean, eat healthy, and fully enjoy your special occasion meals.
Yeah, because I said if you want a piece of pumpkin or whatever pie you eat at Christmas, but you know that following week you're like, I was spot on. Good, have two pieces. It's not going to hurt anything, but again, everything's in moderation when you handle like,
and it's one meal.
Bad
stuff. A holiday meal is one meal.
It can't go,
it can't go for 3 days. It's one meal. Special
and it's
occasion,
like day five.
It's a special occasion meal. I mean, I will say I do like the noontime to 5 p.m. eat straight through special occasion. That's like kind of
fun. I mean,
fun.
You have to use nutrition. You have to use common sense.
Common sense.
Like, and it really, once you get the hang of it, you're just like, well, okay, that makes sense, right? And it really boils down to common sense.
Common sense.